just for a few minutes, turn your Bibles to the book of Numbers, chapter 11. And Numbers chapter 11, and we're going to look at verse 1. 11, Numbers 11, verse 1. And when the people complained, it displeased the Lord. The Lord heard it, and his anger was kindled, and the fire of the Lord burnt among them and consumed them that were in the uttermost part of the camp. Amen. Amen. For just a few minutes, I want to find a point of thanksgiving. Find a point of thanksgiving. As we all stand here today on this Thanksgiving Day, all may not be well. We may have problems, we may have issues that we are dealing with, sickness, financial hardships, job losses. Things may not go the way they may not be going the way we want them to go. And so we find ourselves sometimes in the complaining mode. And one thing I've learned several things about complaining is that complaining never helps the situation. I found out that complaining displeases God. And it also does not give God the glory and the credit. And I found out that complaining glorifies the devil. And I found out that complaining does not make me feel any better. So I will stand here today and say that I never complain, but I will say that I try not to. I try not to make it a practice in my life because I know that complaining will not give glory and honor to God. I'm reminded of a sermon I heard an old preacher preach back in my younger days at revival. The Reverend O.A. Hester, he came to preach revival for my dad at Jumbo. And he preached a sermon from the book of Job, and his title was, Making the Best Out of the Best. And that title has stuck with me down through the years. Sometimes you find yourself in a similar situation, a messy situation, but through God, you can make the best out of it. And the way to make the best out of a bad situation is through Thanksgiving. We have to always find a point of Thanksgiving because 1 Thessalonians 5:18 says, in everything, give thanks. But this is the will of God in Christ concerning you. We have to always find, no matter how dark it is, no matter what the problem is, we have to always find a point of Thanksgiving and know that it's a mind thing. Is how we perceive things, how we see things. And we need to know that the devil will always distort our vision and blow things up. You can get a bad report from the doctor and the devil will just blow it all up and make you think that your life is already in. Am I right about it? But you can take that same bad report and say, by his stripes I'm healed, that I'm going to be all right. I hear what the doctor say. I'm not denying his report. I'm just putting a positive thought on it. We have to find a point of thanksgiving. No matter what's going wrong in our lives, we have to find a point of thanksgiving. And so we find here in the scripture that the children of Israel were in the wilderness. They were in the wilderness, and God had made all kind of provisions for them. God had worked miracles in their lives, and they were in complaining mode. God had sent manna from heaven. And the Bible says in that Numbers 11, said, and when the people complained, it displeased the Lord. So whenever we complain, it displeases the Lord. And you know, he allows to complain some. You know, if you read through the Psalms, there were many psalms who complained about the plight they were in. He allows to complain a little bit, but don't complain all day. So Somebody said, if your dog tired at night, they call you ground all day. So when we complain and we growl and we're displeased, it really affects us not only spiritually but physically. Our blood pressure goes up, our diabetes goes out of control, and things get wrong in the body whenever we find ourselves in that complaining mode. And so that's the reason I like this song. I've had some good days. I've had some healing time. I've had some weary days, some sleepless nights, but when I look around and I think things over, all of my good days outweigh my bad days. The good will always outweigh the bad, no matter how you spice it, no matter how you look at it. So as we face this Thanksgiving day, let us find a point of Thanksgiving. Even in the small things. If it's nothing but waking up in the morning, open our eyes, whether we have the right turkey or not, whether we have the right chicken or not, whether we have the right turkey, the dressing, gravy, whatever the case might be, we want to thank God for whatever He does, because He's good, and He's good all the time. So many people are not here, so many people. And even when we have pain, thank you, Lord, I can feel the pain. Some people don't even know they're hurt. They don't know things are wrong in the body. You know, it used to bother me that when my hair got thin, it used to bother me that I didn't have much hair, but something don't have in it. But I get to thank God that I still have a head. It'll draw other people, but complaining, all it'll do is when people hear you complain, you're going to see them sneaking out. You're going to see them leaving you. But start praising God. It's contagious. It's contagious. Praising God is contagious. When you talk about the goodness of the Lord, the songwriter was right. When he said, when I think of the goodness of Jesus and all He's done for me, my soul cried out, hallelujah. I thank God for saving me. Find a song, find a scripture, find a prayer. We have a good time here today. We're not going to hold you, amen. But find a point of Thanksgiving. Let us not stay in that complaining mode. Yeah, complain a little bit. But don't complain all day, all week. Don't complain every time somebody sees you. Because God is good. Can you say God is good? So good to me and my family this year. I can't even begin to even tell you. It would take me all day. And I still couldn't tell it all. We got some issues, we got some problems we deal with around the house and in our health. But thank God we're here, we're alive, and we're well. I can wave my hand. Let's sing a little bit of that. If I could say a word.
If I could say a word, if I could say a word, if I could say. Cotter's there. And who else is here? And good to see Sister Adams and Good Hope, Virginia Adams and her mother. And it's good to see you all. Who else is there? Please, today. Hey, Brother Earl. I'm so glad to see you, Earl. It's been years. Just one was very inspiring. Good to see all of you with us today. We're going to close out. I'm going to ask Minister Timothy Green if he'll pray our prayer for the sick and shut in and grace washing and as we come together for our closing prayer. Amen. And one thing I've got is any invitation. If they don't want you to unsaved, we want you to accept Christ as the Lord and Savior. We want to give you an opportunity to do that. Amen. So let us join together as Minister Green will lead us in our prayer for the sick, the bereaved families, and for that. While we're celebrating this, there's some families that are preparing for funerals. Yeah, and we want to pray for that.
Amen. Yeah.